Oh, for Pete's sake. no.
Second best man, my name is Jason. The DJ stole my thunder, but that's okay. We're gonna give him another round of applause. This is awesome. We should be here today. He's giving his card, and all of them are gonna do service. So as I said, my name is Jason. I'm married to Matt's sister, Kelly, my beautiful wife. Thank you, thank you. So today, this day, is our 11-year anniversary.
Woo!
So, hold your applause. I'd like to thank 276 of you for coming on to our 11-year anniversary. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I'm not a crier, although tonight might bring something, but I'm not a crier, and certainly not a crier at work. Although I have been known to make people cry at work, yes. But I'm not a crier. But a few weeks back when we learned that Austin got deployed, Matt gave me a call at work. And he said, Jay, I'd like to ask you to be one of my best men. And that day, Matt, I cried, and then I cried at work. And thank you for that. And I also lost a lot of street cred at work. But thanks, bud. So anyhow, enough of the sappy stuff. Are we ready to roast Matt? Are we ready to roast Matt? Let's roast his ass. Okay, ain't gonna be that bad. Ain't gonna be that bad. Ain't gonna be that bad.
Bring it.
All right, when I first met Matt, actually the first time I met the DiBenedetto family, Kelly actually took me up to their place in Grass Valley one of the weekends in college. And Matt was about 7 years old. And this kid had everything. I swear, I hadn't been as envious of a seven-year-old since I was 6 years old. This kid had everything. He had quads, go-karts, he had motorcycles, he had a track that went all around the property. And he had a hot blonde sister. So I was hooked. But the DiBenedettos haven't gotten rid of me since. I was hooked, I tell you. So no, he's the sweetest kid, but I'll tell you what, he was the scrawniest little kid. I swear, you could have wrapped a dish towel around this kid 5-6 times. He was so scrawny, but he was like the perfect height. You just put him right here, just perfect height, just lean on him. Just call him a little armrest. But no, from day one, he had my heart. I swear, he had my heart. He was something special. I know, y'all think that special. Yeah, he was special, like rode the short bus to school. Yeah, he was special. Like special, like Forrest Gump mama said, those are my magic shoes. Yeah, that was Forrest Gump right there. But no, he's special. He had me from day one in my heart. And I actually got to experience one of my first DiBenedetto stories. If anybody knows me in this room, I've told you this story about 100 or 200 times. This is my favorite DiBenedetto story. We'll call it the banana peel story. Okay? So it's that first weekend when I met them, and we were all having breakfast, and Kelly was having a banana. That's her staple for breakfast. And so she finished her banana and got done, and she got up, and I thought she was just going to walk to go put it in the garbage, you know, like we all do. Instead, she got up and she walked the other way across the living room. to the back slider, opened up the back slider, reeled back, and threw it out the door. Over the balcony, down below the hill. Like, what kind of hillbilly did I just get involved with? So she must have saw the confusion in my eyes. She said, well, no, the deer eat them. And they lived up in the hills, because I'm a city boy. I mean, I see a couple deer, but I never met any. Okay, I guess they eat banana peels. So anyhow, later on that day, Matt and I, I'm gonna circle back to Matt. Matt and I were walking around the property. He was showing me all his go-karts and whatnot. And we get to going around the back of the house. And I'm walking, all of a sudden I stop, and I look down, and at my feet are hundreds of decomposing banana peels. And that day, I, Matt, and the DiBenedetto family learned that deer do not eat banana peels. So Taylor, we're not gonna roast you. You're too sweet for that. Plus, just earlier today, you committed yourself to be roasted for the rest of your life, marrying this one.
I know.
But you are sweet. You're the sweetest girl I've ever met, I swear. This is a Southern girl in a frame in an art gallery right here. She's the sweetest girl. Like I said, I'm from the West Coast, and I don't get to meet a whole lot of Southern girls, but when you look in the dictionary, this is the one. And man, you got her. Good job, buddy. So I'm an only child, and so when I'm married into the DiBenedetto family, I got a lot of brothers and sisters along the way, which is amazing. And today I get another wonderful sister, and thank you. Aww. Aww. Yeah. Good, my husband. All right, I got some advice. We're about to wrap this up. It's not too much. Some advice. Hang on, let's talk to your wife. Taylor. They say the best way to a man's heart is through his stomach. That's true. Yeah. I said, don't aim so high. I'm just saying. Matt, now I want you to look at me very intently. Very intently. A lot of people in this room have been witness to your Snapchats. And the torture that you put this beautiful woman to. And all I gotta say is, I'll tell you, look at me, intently. Revenge is a dish best served cold.
Don't judge us. It's sounding better than the
mini.
Wait a minute. These are empty. Excuse us, waiter. Please pour us plenty. Are we happy for ya? You bet your asses. So come please join us, everyone, and raise your glasses.
Tables and everybody sat around, and I want to thank all of you for coming.
It means a lot to me. I want to thank, I really need to thank J.D. Gibbs, Joe Gibbs, and Steve D'Souza for opening the door for Matt. It means the world to me. I need to thank Curtis Key Racing for giving Matt the opportunity last year, and I need to thank the whole 83 team for what they've done for Matt and Ron Devine. I can't thank you enough for what you've done for my son. You've given us a dream that I can't even begin to tell you what it was, watching him go on that racetrack. It means the world to us. So it does that. I want to say something to Matt. There's two things I want to say to Matt. One thing that I used to always say to him when he was probably about 8 years old, was that if one day we could turn around and look at each other after we were doing the racing and say we had a good time together, that was all it was. And if we got one ride, one day, and one race car, that was icing on the cake. Well, they've given me more than icing. They've given me the whole cake. But the second thing I used to say to Matt, there's a song that he absolutely hates. And every time he get in the race car, I'd be on top of the trailer, and I'd hit the radio. I go, "Hey, Matt." He goes, "What, Dad?" I go, "Press Rat Warthog closed down their shop. They didn't want to. It was all they had got. Selling atonal apples, amplified heat, and Press Rat's collection of dog legs and feet." And I'd stop. And he'd go, "Okay, Dad." I go, "I'm not done." Sadly, they left, telling no one goodbye. Press Rat wore red jumpers, and Warthog is striped tie. Between them, they carried a three-legged sack, went straight around the corner, and never came back. That was a song from the band Creed. It's called Press Rat Warthog, which Matt hates so much. The reason I said that to you, Matt, so much is because I wanted you to have fun. Because I never knew where this journey was going to take us. I never knew. I really, as much as I think everybody thinks we had Spring Cup in mind, we really did. We just had fun in mind. And I want you and Taylor to know that Press Rat Warthog means something special to me. Have fun with the rest of your life. Thank you so much.
And that's what they don't see. Mm-mm. That's
getting out of Denver. When the stores make you drool, just like pasta fossil, that's amore. When you dance down the street with a cloud at your feet, you're in love. When you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signore. Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
Everybody have to sing.
But I always wondered, and I found out, and a lot of this, and Tony was talking about their dream in NASCAR, and he's really blessed, but he's a good young driver. Nobody's asked. Some of you know, some of you don't. A lot of them, first of all, you mind if I do this real quick? The owners of car number 83, will you stand up over there? The owners of car 83, stand up so they'll know who you are. Don't think about my camera. Yeah, there you go. There's a guy that makes the dream come true, okay? And he's got some of his pit crew over here and some of the guys on his team, his GMs here. I'll raise your hand. Stand up real quick, everybody, and then we got to go on. We want to dance, huh? All BK Racing, stand up. If I have to point you out, we're going to buy you some short buses to ride around on. Okay. Now, at this time, it's time to get down to some serious stuff. And he's starting to strip. Race car drivers have taken on a new name. What? Come on. Now, what if we haven't got in the back? He's got more room. You ain't going nowhere yet.
But there is something that I must confess
to you.
Okay.
I don't see.
And what this is, guys, we got to make lines somewhere, so we'll have to make a line through here. But for right now, they're at my command. You didn't know this was really going to happen, did you? So we're going to start some slow music. And what's going to happen is we're going to have some fun. I used to tell people I did this because I looked at the gift table, and you guys are a bunch of tightwads. I'm going to skip all the bull. The real reason I do this is a lot of times you go to weddings, and this wedding is a very nice wedding, well put together. But the one thing you always miss out on is when you go back and look at your pictures 15 or 20 years from now, they've got pictures of them, their family, and their wedding party. That's it. So by doing this, I give you guys a chance to come up here, and you're going to dance with them, and he's going to take your picture. And therefore, they can look back in 20 years, and they'll have pictures of you guys and what you look like years ago, just like they've been showing all night over there. It's a good memory. But at this time, I've got a bowl in front of Taylor, and I got one in front of Matt. To dance with them, you need to form a line, and you have to put something green in there. A dollar, a five, a 10, a 50, a 100, and you can dance with Taylor. You can put...
What if it's all guys that come up and dance with me?
I'm going to cover that part too. Ladies, if you want to dance with Matt, you have to put money in his bucket. Now listen. First of all, here's what's the important thing. Guys, you know Matt. If you see somebody dancing with Taylor and Matt don't know who it is and you think he might get mad, it is your obligation as a friend to get in line, put money in that bowl, tap him on his shoulder, and set his butt down. Now, if he gets back up and gets back in line and he puts more money back in the bucket, it's okay. You're getting paid now, okay? So that's fine. Ladies, the same thing over here. Now, wait a minute. Well, we ain't done yet. Guys, if you want to dance with Matt, guys, that's okay. I don't mind. But if I have to figure out which one is leading, you better put 20 in there at least. Now, we take 50s and 100s. If you don't have money, leave your debit card with your PIN number. We'll send it back in a couple days. But now we're going to start some slow music. Ladies, I need you to form a line. Gentlemen, form a line. Do. All right. Yeah, and the money goes to them. It doesn't go to me. All this money will go to Matt and Taylor, and it'll help them out, okay? So start some slow music. Let's do it. Let's get it moving so we can crank it up. Hers is hers, and what is yours is hers too. There you go. Thank you guys so much.
Hey, Tony, they're all over there. Thank you. gives this woman to be married to this man?
Taylor to be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish until death parts us.
To love and to cherish until death parts us.
And I pledge you my faithfulness.
I pledge you my faithfulness.
I favor. In the presence of God and these witnesses. Take you, Matt, to be my husband. To have and to hold from this day forward. For better, for worse. For richer and for poorer. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Until death parts us. And I pledge you my faithfulness. You want to have the exchanging of rings? Receive this ring, Matt. Receive this ring.
Receive this ring.
As a pledge and a token of wedded love.
The pledge and token of wedded love.
And faithfulness.
And faithfulness.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr.